This video demonstrates how to measure RPM and acoustic data from rotating machinery using LMS Test Lab Signature. The equipment needed for this demonstration includes a tachometer, a microphone, a SCADAS XS, and LMS Test Lab Signature loaded on a PC. In this video, a Stirling engine will be used as the rotating machinery being measured. A tachometer measures speed in RPM. When using an optical tach like the one shown here, place a small strip of reflective tape on the flywheel of the Stirling engine and aim the eye of the tach towards the tape. The RPM is determined by timing the reflective tape passing by the tachometer. Make sure that the XS is connected to the PC through the USB port. Open LMS Test Lab Signature by double-clicking the icon. Open a new project using the white rectangle icon. Under File, the project can be saved under a specific name in any computer directory using the Save As button. It will have a .lms extension. Start in the Channel Setup worksheet. Turn on the TACO1 channel, which has the tachometer attached. By default, the Input 1 channel is already turned on. For this demonstration, the microphone is attached to Input 1. The channel group ID of the first input should be set to Acoustic, and the input mode should be changed to ICP. In the calibration worksheet, we will calibrate the microphone. Change the unit to pascals. Make sure that frequency is 1000 Hz and the level is 94 with dB RMS as units. These are the settings for this specific calibrator. Other calibrators may be different. Attach the calibrator to the microphone to begin the calibration process. Press the check button and then the start button. While the microphone is being calibrated, the sensitivity being measured will be shown under New Sensitivity in the Channels window. Once the status shows finished, press Accept to use the newly measured sensitivity values for the microphone. The new sensitivity will replace the actual sensitivity in both the Channel Setup worksheet and the Calibration worksheet automatically. Ensure that the rotating machinery that is being used is running. In this demonstration, we will be using a lighter to start our Stirling engine. In the Tracking Setup worksheet, set the pulses per rev to 1. This way, the tachometer calculates RPM using only the one piece of tape placed on the flywheel as a reference. Here is a good point to check that the results being read by the tachometer make sense relative to what is expected. A trigger level can manually be changed to fit testing needs by typing in a trigger value or moving the black bar in the window up or down. If a trigger is not set properly, RPM will be measured incorrectly. For example, if the trigger is set too high or too low, RPM will be calculated as 0. Set the trigger level to where the tachometer pulse passes through the trigger level. You should see an RPM being measured. There are multiple options for measurement modes, which include tracked and stationary. Tracked should be used when measuring a run-up or a run-down. Stationary should be used for a steady RPM. Set the measurement mode to tracked, because in this case we will be using a run-down. Set tracking method to TACO. And then change the slope method to down. For this Stirling engine, we will change the minimum to 300, the maximum to 800, and the increment to 2. Move to the Acquisition Setup worksheet. Set the bandwidth to 4096 Hz and resolution to 2 Hz. Even though human hearing is good to 20,000 Hz, the sound made by the Stirling engine is significant up to 4,000 Hz. Move to the Online Processing worksheet. You may need to use Control Page Up on your keyboard if the worksheets are not visible due to your screen resolution. It is possible to have LMS Test Lab Signature process the data while it is being acquired. For example, go to the Acoustic tab at the top of the worksheet and change the final weighting to A. Additional processing functions like overall level and orders can be calculated while the acquisition is in progress as well. Go to the Orders Sections tab and add orders 1, 3, and 6 as shown and press Enter. Go to the Overall Level tab and make sure the Overall Level checkbox is checked. In the Measure worksheet, make sure that the checkbox that says Save Throughput is checked. This is very important because it saves raw time data for listening later and for reprocessing. Go to the Data Explorer and open up the Online Data tab in the browsing tree by double-clicking on the folder. Open the Fixed Sampling folder where there are three more folders, Monitor, Instantaneous, and Rundown. These allow us to set up the data we view even before the data itself is taken. Open the Monitor folder. The Monitor folder always shows the live data regardless of if a measurement is in progress or not. Open a front-back display behind the pop-up Data Explorer window. Open the Frequency folder and click and drag the frequency spectrum to the display. Press the arm button and you can view the live data without the measurement being in progress. Open a 2x1 display with a front back and a color map. From the Rundown folder in the Data Explorer, open the Waterfall folder and the Acoustic folder and add the Auto Power to the color map. Open the Sections folder and click and drag the overall level and orders into the front back display. You can use the Shift key on your keyboard to select all three orders at once and click and drag them into the front back display. Close the Data Explorer and we will now begin taking measurements. Press the Start button. We have set a start RPM of 800, so measurements will not be taken until 800 RPM has been reached. We will blow out the candle so as to begin our rundown. When the rundown has finished, select to keep the data and press Disarm. Now we can begin post-processing. In the color map display, right-click on the data and add a single order cursor. Depending on your data, you can determine where important orders are by zooming in and moving the cursor around. If you want to view the order amplitude versus RPM, open a detached display and a front-back layout. Right-click on the order cursor and pick Processing. Drag and drop the order section data into the front-back window and close the pop-up window. You can now move the cursor around the color map and see the amplitude versus RPM change accordingly. You can now close the pop-up window. You can also right-click on the color map and add a single X cursor. This will allow you to find frequencies that stand out in the data. For example, we have a frequency band from roughly 400 Hz to 500 Hz. Right-click again and choose to audio replay the data. You can listen to the recording of the Stirling engine and add filters to isolate or remove particular sounds while you are listening. For example, we can add a 400 Hz to 550 Hz band stop filter to eliminate those frequencies that stand out. Replay the data. You can check and uncheck the filter to hear the difference between the data with and without the filter. Notice that there is a lot of frequency content above 600 Hz. We can add a low pass filter at 600 Hz to get rid of these high frequencies. This concludes the video. Thanks for watching and enjoy using LMS Test Lab Signature.